Hello everyone, welcome to mbbsdisease.com. So today we are going to start a new series of urine analysis, and the complete urine analysis includes urine volume, specific gravity, proteinuria, hematuria and cast. So in this video we will discuss about proteinuria, and the next upcoming videos we will discuss about urine volume, specific gravity, hematuria and cast. So please subscribe our channel for those videos also. Now let us discuss about proteinuria. So firstly, we should know what are the normal range of protein in the urine. So normal protein excretion is around less than 150 milligram per day. This is normal total protein excretion. This is less than 150 milligram per day. And the normal albumin excretion should be less than 30 milligram per deciliter. And a normal main protein excretion, the main protein is TAM horse fowl protein, which is excreted in the urine normally, and the normal value range from 70 to 75 milligram per deciliter. So these are the normal values. Now coming to the causes of proteinuria, so there are certain causes. We can also say that these are the types of proteinuria. So the first type is orthostatic proteinuria, second is overflow proteinuria, the third one is glomerular, and the fourth is tubular. These types of proteinuria depends on its cause. So as the name suggests, orthostatic, it might be because of orthostatic, this is because of overflow of the protein, glomerular because of defect in the glomeruli, and tubular defect in the tubules of nephrons. Now we will discuss about orthostatic proteinuria. Now continuing with orthostatic proteinuria, suppose these are the arterioles which are coming from systemic vessels to the glomeruli. Now this is efferent renal arteriole and this is efferent means the it coming from heart and it goes toward the heart. Now suppose this is glomeruli. So what happens in the orthostatic proteinuria? Prolonged standing leads to decrease in venous return, and this decrease in venous return leads to decrease in cardiac output, and the body responses as increase in renin, and this renin angiotensin system will also increase angiotensin. This will increase, and this angiotensin will affect directly to efferent renal arteriole. So what happened to the efferent renal arteriole? It will become constricted. So what will happen? It will become constricted. Okay, so the more pooling will occur here, and the GFR will also increase because of the more pooling, and the protein excretion will increase. In the orthostatic type of proteinuria, there should be less than 1 gram per day excretion of the protein. So this is about the orthostatic proteinuria. Now let us discuss about second type of proteinuria, which is overflow proteinuria. So what occurs in the overflow proteinuria? The protein amount is very much high. These black dots denotes the protein, and these are very high in the blood. So this will come into the glomeruli, and it will not be reabsorbed from the tubules. So it will come in urine. So what occurs in overflow? The protein in the blood is very much high. It is more than the tubular reabsorption capacity. So the proteinuria occurs. The example of overflow proteinuria is light chain excretion in the multiple myeloma. This is also known as Benz-Jones proteinuria, because these light chains are known as Benz-Jones protein. So Benz-Jones proteinuria. Now let us discuss about glomerular and tubular along with each other. So the glomerular type, the main protein which is to be excreted is albumin. Albumin is excreted in glomerular type of proteinuria. And in tubular type, which is the main protein? It is TAM horse fowl protein, which is a normal protein, but The normal range is 70 to 75 milligram per day. Now here is less than 2 gram per day. So the amount of normal protein is increased. So this is also known as proteinuria. This is tubular proteinuria. And the amount of glomerular proteinuria should be more than 2 gram per day. Okay. And this is also associated with RBC cast. RBC cast are present in glomerular while there is no RBC cast in tubular. So this is all for proteinuria. In the next video, we will discuss about urine volume, specific gravity, and hematuria and cast related to urine analysis. So please subscribe our channel for more videos, and like this video and share this video with your friends. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe our channel. Thank you.